Welcome to SELCOtv. This is Rachel Gray, Information Services Librarian here at SELCO. Today we're going to be talking about filling the pull list. Your pull list must run every business day in time for delivery to pick up your library's items. Everything on your pull list must be sent to the requesting library unless it is marked missing. And please do not delete other libraries' patrons' requests or manipulate statuses to be anything other than missing. So if you're doing your pull list and you cannot find a copy of 101 Dalmatians on your shelf, mark it missing so that the next library in line can fill that request for the patron. And of course, in case you're wondering why your library was selected to fill this request, if your copy of 101 Dalmatians has been the longest since it has circled, you'll be the library that is chosen. So if your copy has not circled for a year and a half, but the library down the street circled theirs last week, yours will be selected. So what we're going to do to get to the pull list is we're going to open up the circulation file, and in Horizon that's right over here, and then we're going to go to circulation reports. And we're going to go to the requests menu and request pull list. And this does take a while to run. It is going through all of Horizon and selecting the items for you to be pulling from your shelves. So at this point, I'm going to pause my video, since it's not very interesting just to wait for the screen to change, and we'll pick up in just a moment. And here is my pull list. I'm pretending to be from Faribault Buckham Memorial Library today, since they've got lots of items on their request list. You can see that there's no real rhyme or reason as to how this list is ordered. So I'm going to sort by collection and then by call number. This way, when I'm going through my library, it's easy for me to grab all the book fiction books and then book fantasy, fiction juvenile, and then so on. And it's all in order for me. Before you continue, we do ask or recommend that you print this list so you have something physical to take around with you onto the shelves. Once you go to your shelves and get all your items, you'll want to come back and hit list pulled. This tells Horizon that all of the items have been pulled from your pull list and that you have completed it for the day. You will get a warning window that pops up that will tell you that this action will bind items to requests as they appear in the list, and they will no longer appear in any other pull lists you run today. I'm actually going to say no or X out of that because I don't want Horizon not to know about these requests for Faribault. So once I've done all of this, I can close this report window. And again, I'm getting this because it's telling me that this list will appear on subsequent pull lists because I've not hit that list pulled button. So that's just fine. Hit OK. And then I'm going to go to my check-in window, and I'm going to scan in all the items, and this is where it'll tell me where these items are going, so what label to put on them. So Owatonna might get some. I might have some for my own patrons in Faribault. Some might be going through ILL to a library outside of the region, etc. So again, if you cannot find an item, it will show up on your pull list the next day unless it is marked missing. The pull list will refresh itself at midnight and will release all unfilled requests. So if you have to mark an item missing, the next day another library will be assigned that. And then once you're done with everything else, you'll want to stack everything going to the same location and use the white routing slips to label each stack. And please be sure to use the correct delivery codes to make sure that your items get where they need to go. And this is all I have for you on pull lists. If you have any questions or comments or need clarification on anything, don't hesitate to contact us with the help desk. That's what we're here for. And until next time, thank you for watching SELCOtv.